Good evening, everyone, and welcome back to Cask 529. I'm Brian.
And I'm Shauna.
Tonight, we're coming to you from a different location. It's a little quieter where we're at tonight. And we're going to take a look at Heaven Hill Bourbon tonight. This is distilled and bottled by Heaven Hill Distillery. It's a 7-year, 100-proof bourbon. I have not ever had it. Have you had it?
I have not had it, no.
Usually we'll try to at least get a little taste of it ahead of time, but tonight we broke the seal and poured it. So,
it's 100 proof?
It is 100 proof.
Yep. And it's the Heaven Hills Bottled in Bond edition. And so, of course, since we're only tasting the one, we're back to playing our game.
Playing the game. Shauna's going to probably get more points on me tonight.
We'll see about that. But I believe where we left off, I'm at 5 and you're at 2.
I believe that's right.
Yep. So, again, I don't even know a whole lot about Heaven Hill Distillery, to be honest, so I would like to learn a little bit more about that at some point.
Yeah, it's a totally new product to us. It's not an allocated bottle here in Ohio. It did show up at our local liquor store on a drop day. Where we're at this weekend, we see it sitting around a lot. That wasn't the case down home, but.
Okay, well, I'm anxious to try it.
Yeah. I kind of sense a little sweet.
You know, I didn't even look up to see if we could even find what the mash bill was on this.
Yeah, I didn't look.
Maybe when we look to see what the tasting notes are, we can find out what that is.
First impression?
It's sweet.
Yeah, I'm going to actually, I've never done it this soon, but I'm going to go ahead and put a penny on honey. I kind of get a honey.
I definitely get honey as well. And so we're probably going to have a penny on the same one.
Maybe I'll get a point. I won't lose any points that way. There was a little heat, but it wasn't real heavy. But it was consistent for me from the front of my palate all the way down. I had it.
I have to say, this is a good bourbon, but I'm not picking up a ton of flavors.
I'm going to say it's toasted oak.
So I'm definitely getting the honey that you're getting. I am getting some vanilla. And I agree, it is definitely some toasted oak. There's not a char on here, but there is just a slight char. It's not a heavy char.
No, I don't. I agree with that. It's a really nice pour,
yeah.
Considering that's a neck pour. It's only been open for
maybe 15 minutes.
Yeah, at the most.
But I mean, I'm not picking up a whole lot of flavors. It's just kind of, and honestly, the flavor, it does go away quickly.
Yeah, I got the slight amount of toasted oak, and I got the honey, Those were pretty consistent. They didn't really come in waves. They were both right there and stayed until they faded.
Mm-hmm.
For 100 proof, a lot of people that don't drink higher proof bourbons would be surprised with this. They aren't going to get all those flavors, I don't believe, unless we're missing something.
No. I have to taste it one more time. See if I can pick up any more flavors. On the nose, I'm really just getting... I'm not getting much burn on the nose, just a little bit of sweetness. Not a whole lot of...
There may be some pepper in there with the heat.
I'm not tasting any type of nut.
I'm going to say there's some pepper in there. Black pepper.
Definitely no floral.
No, I didn't get any of that. Nothing that put me in mind of a chocolate or anything like that.
No. I'm really not even picking up any type of berry or any type of...
No.
I'm going to have to put mine on toasted oak, too. Knowing it's just a slight char is what I'm picking up, but there's no char there, so.
There's just not, maybe as it's open longer, it'll present itself different, but initially, it's just not very complex.
It's not. It's not bad.
What's there is good.
Yes.
It just doesn't go in depth.
Right. So it's a $49.99 bottle here.
That's
in
correct.
Ohio.
Yep.
Do I think it's worth $49.99? I'm going to say it's more like a $30 bottle probably in my eyes.
Yeah, I'd say probably 30 to 35.
Yeah.
And I feel like we've had bourbon in that price range that's as good or more complex. I don't want to say better. But as good or more complex as this is.
Yeah. Well, let's see what is in this. Okay. Aroma, we should have picked up warm notes of vanilla, honey, and a rich caramel sweetness.
Okay, so you got vanilla?
Well, that's the aroma. The tasting, smooth, warm, and sweet with a subtle rye spice note. Caramel, I really didn't get the caramel.
No, I didn't either.
Honey, we both got honey, so we both have a point there. And just enough oak and char to round out the richness.
I'd say we both got that point.
We both got 2 points. Because my other one was vanilla, and you have black pepper.
Yep.
We missed the caramel, is what we missed. And I truly did not pick that up in it. The rye spice, you were picking up some pepper, so that was probably just the rye in it. So tonight we actually tied.
That's progress for me.
You did good,
I'm impressed.
Babe. You tied.
I'm happy.
I'm looking real quick to see if I can find if it has what the mash bill is in it right here. And it makes me feel better to know that even the tasting notes, there wasn't many, many things to pick out from it. So
even what was written was not complex.
Yeah.
I expected a little more out of that.
I could not find the mash bills right here, but I will tell you that Heaven Hill, it looks like it is also bottled along with Elijah Craig, Larceny, and Evan Williams.
Okay. So Elijah Craig's a solid pour.
Yep, I know that you
We have not tried Larceny. I don't believe we've had Evan Williams also.
We have not. No.
Larceny's been on my radar. I've been afraid to pull the trigger on it.
Yeah, so that's a place that we should, because I know we both like Elijah Craig.
Yep.
When we've had that. So we should definitely, next time we're in Kentucky, which hopefully won't be too far away.
No, we're actually, I looked at the calendar last night. We're out of jail at Buffalo Trace next week. So we'll be able to get a full allotment of whatever they offer while we're there.
Yeah.
So as far as would we recommend the Heaven Hill, you know, maybe if you're in a restaurant, you'll want to try a pour of it, or if you know someone that's got some, try a pour. I don't know if I'd go out and buy it before I tried it.
Yeah, not a bad pour at all. It just doesn't, for $50, I don't feel like it has.
No, it's not.
The depth that I would want.
I'm not super mad that I paid the $50 for it.
No.
But when that's gone, I don't know that I'm going to run right back out unless something changes.
Right.
You know, as we get down through it, but I'm not going to run right back out and buy another bottle.
Nope. I agree with that. So the good news is we tied tonight. So
I did not lose ground, so it's still 5-2.
Well, actually, it'll be 7-4.
7-4.
Yep, so you're just still behind by 3. So hopefully
it sounds closer now.
It does. It sounds a lot closer. shoot. Well, this was fun. A little side.
Yeah, I don't know if we'll have another show before we go back home. Possibly you'll see another show from the same setting.
Yep.
If not, I know we've got some things planned for next week. We've have to confirm some things, but it looks like we're going to have some good content coming next week. So I think with that, hit that subscribe button, hit the like button, drop us some comments if you would, anything. Hey, do this, try this, go look for that. I think you're crazy. I think it's a good pour, whatever, anything.
Yep.
Do you have anything else?
I do not. Thanks, everybody.
Thanks, and thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time, guys.
Yeah.